So we're currently standing at the Lake Campus construction site. A few months ago, this was just a bunch of fields, but in a couple of years, it's going to be full of graduate housing and other infrastructure for the university.
I'm Harry Shapiro, mechanical and aerospace engineering major at Princeton University, class of 2022.
And I'm Ted Bohr, energy plant director at Princeton University. That's me in the energy plant there on the left. You may have noticed all the construction projects around campus. Many of those projects are related to the university's rapid transition to cleaner energy as we seek to reach net zero by 2046 or sooner. In the next few minutes, Harry and I are going to do our best to show you what's happening, explain how it works, and why it's important. It all starts with something called GeoExchange.
That's a drilling rig. Look closely, and you can see the auger spinning. These rigs are drilling GeoExchange borehole wells, each hole about 600 to 850 feet deep. Across campus, these rigs are creating more than 1,000 of these holes.
There's black plastic tubing being inserted into those holes. Notice that the tubing is doubled up as it goes down into the hole. That's because it's a closed loop through which water will circulate.
Once the tubing's buried in the ground, it looks like this. There can be dozens of GeoExchange boreholes on just a single site, each about 20 feet apart from each other.
A good question to ask at this point is, why are we drilling all these holes? And the short answer is that GeoExchange allows us to completely change the way we heat and cool buildings on campus in a way that's far more efficient than we can do it now. GeoExchange is really a storage mechanism, so in the summer we can take heat out of the building and store it in the ground, and in the winter we can remove heat from the ground and deliver it back to the building.
When we want to move heat to or from the wells, it'll be piped underground to a heat pump plant. On the main Princeton campus, this plant is called Tiger. At Lake Campus, it's called Tiger Cup. Think of them as a much larger version of the air conditioner in your home. It uses a combination of the heat off the GeoExchange field, as well as electricity, to produce heating and cooling for campus buildings.
Our heat pumps will be powered by renewable electricity. They will displace most of today's combustion-based heating and cooling from the cogeneration plant.
Welcome to the last stage of our tour. We're standing right behind Frisk Campus Center, where workers are installing two large insulated 20-inch hot water pipes. These pipes are the final stage of energy's journey to heat campus buildings. This network of underground water pipes is what's now being installed all across campus. The new hot water pipes will replace steam pipes, which were previously used for campus heating, but had much higher thermal losses and weren't compatible with GeoExchange or heat pumps. Chilled water for cooling is already supplied to campus buildings through a similar system.
The transition from steam to hot water heating is a once-in-a-century activity. It's a singular moment in the university's history. Right now, we're installing infrastructure that will be used for the next 100 years and allow us to transition to a net zero carbon future.